Rehoboam, Jeroboam now has 10 tribes, so you have the lion's share of the people. He knew that each year, Jerusalem, Zion, the city of God, the place where God chose to set his name, was the place that if men went up at the time of year to sacrifice, their hearts would be turned and they might move from Jeroboam and cleave to Rehoboam. And so he said, right, I've got 800,000 men. I've got holy people with me. I've got a bigger church following. I've got a bigger offering plate. I've got a bigger choir. I have bigger buildings. I've got status. But something was missing. He didn't have God. Rehoboam had less than half. And he had Judah. A text from 1 Kings 10, 1982. I don't know who else was there, in Forest Gate, Bishop Mantle's church in East London. And Bishop called it cheap religion. Please light up that day. Bishop preach cheap religion. What Jeroboam did, he set up a new religious system. He said, if the people go up to Jerusalem, I'm going to lose them. So he went right back to doing what the children of Israel did when Moses was upon the mount, receiving the Ten Commandments, receiving the direction for the people. They built golden calves. But he didn't just build one calf. He built two. This thing became a sin in the eyes of God. He set one at Dan and one in Bethel. So if you can't reach to Dan, go to Bethel. If you can't get to Bethel, go to Dan. Whatever you do, don't go up to Jerusalem. Folks concerned. It's too much for the people. Set the battle in array. and said, "Hear me, O Jeroboam, and all of Israel. Don't you know that the Lord God of Israel gave the kingdom of Israel to David forever, even to him and to his sons by a covenant of sons? I mean, God gave it to us. Yet you, Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, you just a servant. That's where you came from. You was a servant, and because Solomon saw that he was industrious, Solomon set him up over his house. Sometimes we have to watch who we have set up. Some sons of Nebat is in the camp. Don't even have to shout right there. We shout when we get to verse 15. He said, "You're just a servant. Servant of Solomon, who was the son of David. I know you'll rise up and rebel. You're coming to rebel against the Lord. And there's gathered with you. You've got vain men with you. They're the children of Belial now. And they're strengthening themselves. You come against Rehoboam, the son of Solomon, when Rehoboam was young and tender and couldn't withstand them. He was just too young. Didn't understand what he was doing. You take advantage. And now it comes to the point where you want to withstand the kingdom of the Lord and take it out of the hands of the sons of King David just because you're a great multitude. You come with your golden calf." So here he is now, telling Jeroboam and reminding him of the state that he's in now. He said in verse 9, you cast out the rightful priests, the sons of Aaron and the Levites, and you've made yourself priests after the manner of other nations that who have come to you with bullock and rams. You just take them. You just take them in and make them a priest. You just take them and make them priests, and then they start bowing down to gods that are not even gods. Look at the situation that you're in, but as for us, the Lord is with us because we have not forsaken him. And the priests that minister, they're from the rightful line. They burn incense and sacrifices every morning and evening. The showmen and everything is just set in order. Because we're keeping the charge. We are custodians of the covenant relationship between Jehovah and his people. We have not deviated from it. Whilst Abijah was talking all these and showing Jeroboam his situation, Jeroboam was plotting. Say, "All right, we're going to fix you. 800,000 is a whole heap of men. It's 200,000 short of a million. A whole heap of men." So he surrounds them. Abijah still talking at this time. He said, "We got the Lord is our captain. He's ahead of us. And the priests are here with the trumpets, and they're ready to sound the alarm. Don't bother come near us, because you're not going to prosper. You will not win. You won't win this battle because God is our captain." But Jeroboam rushed them, caused an ambushment, come up from behind and before, and Judah cried out. Now, that's natural, because 800,000 rushing 400,000, they started to cry out. But when the trumpet sounded, the men of Judah gave a shout. Now, when I was looking at this text, they have the American. Have we got any Americans in here today? No.
Yes.
And they call this shout. I call it dance. Shout is when you open your mouth. Shout is when you open your mouth. There's seven forms, they said, of praise. And in this context, it's Shabbat. It means open your mouth. Sound the praises of God. When the army began, I remember a time when Elisha was surrounded at Dothan. Yes, the Syrians were round about. And one of the servants woke up in the night, and when he saw the Syrians was there, found their hiding place. place. They rushed back and wake him up and said, "Oh, man of God, what shall we do?" Yeah. Now Elisha, with experience of God, knew that God had delivered him before and God can do it again. You gotta have some experience as well as trusting God. So Elisha did not pray, "Oh God, what are we gonna do? We're surrounded." He just said, "Open the young man's eyes, that he not just see in the natural, the Syrians that surround us, but open his eyes that he could see that they that before us are more than those that be against us." Yes, the enemy will come upon us like a flood. But the Bible tells me when the enemy shall come upon us like a flood, the Holy Ghost will lift up a standard. God is our standard bearer. And if God be for us, tell me who? Who can be against us? So when Elisha said, "Open the young man's eyes," his eyes were open. When he came, he said, "I see round about Jerusalem walls of fire. We have got to see God in the spirit. But we're looking too much with the natural eyes. We can see that the enemy is coming on us left, right, and center, right up in here. But we've got to see the plan of God, that God is working within us. But when God was working with us, we were one nation, we were one people, united under one leader. But who's to know what will happen in the future? I'm not looking for a split, but I'm looking for us to remain united because God is with us." When Abijah looked around and saw the 800,000 men coming, Judah, the tribe of Judah. Judah means praise. Yes. Judah, all they had was Judah and one other tribe. They opened their mouth and begin to shout back. No, no. When you're reaching a situation like this, there was